Next. Here, suppose A plus B is equal 45 or 225. A plus B is equal to 45 or 225. So for this condition, when we apply the tan, so we get a problem in the form of 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B is equal to 1. It's a very important fact. So when we take the cot, when we apply the cot on both sides, then it becomes 1 minus cot A into 1, sorry, this is not 1, this is 2. 1 minus cot B is also 2. Suppose if you want to write the value of 1 plus cot A into 1 plus cot B, for this we are going to get 2 cot A cot B. Okay. Right. This is the other thing. When sum of the two angles, A plus B and A plus B, this type of problem. So when we know, when we got a problem in the form of 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B, or 1 minus cot A into 1 minus cot B, 1 plus cot A into 1 plus cot B. So now add these two angles, A and B. At the time, what we do here? Add these two angles. So then, if, for example, here we have one important problem is there. So listen. So see here. Example. 1 plus tan 30 divided by 1 plus tan 12 into 1 plus tan 32 divided by 1 plus tan 33. Okay, so listen, see. So we write like this. So 1 plus tan 30 into 1 plus tan 32 divided by 1 plus tan 12 into 1 plus tan 33. So you observe this. Here, 1 plus tan A, in numerator and denominator, both, in both numerator and denominator, the terms which are in the form of 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B. 1 plus tan 13, 1 plus tan 32. 13 plus 32, 45. Here also 12 plus 33, 45. That means 2 by 2, it becomes get cancelled. This is the one. Okay. So, that's why you can do that. Next, suppose in this model, A plus B, if A plus B is equal to 135, if A plus B is equal to 135. Is 135 degrees or 315 degrees. Then here also 1 minus tan A into 1 minus tan B. Here we get 2. Next, 1 plus cot A into 1 plus cot B is equals to 2. If you want to write the value of 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan B, so is equal to 2 tan A tan B. So this is the one of the identity in this. Okay. For example, here we have another model is there. So for example, if the proper example, if A plus B is equal to 135, then what is the value of 1 plus cot A into 1 plus cot B? So already given condition, by using this given condition, A plus B is equal to 135, so here also given condition. So that's why answer is directly we can write 2. Suppose you don't know this identity at the time of examination. what we do here means,
so sum of the two angles is 135 now.
So instead of A, we take 45, and instead of B, we are going to take 90.
Substitute in this given problem, we get 1 plus cot 45 and 1 plus cot 90. Okay, so 1 plus cot 45 is 1 and 1 plus cot 90 is 0, it becomes 2. So in this way also we can do this. Okay, so this is the way of the solving problem.
Okay, you have to remember this to write this. Next. Next. Then here, suppose sum of the three angles, suppose if you take sum of the three angles, if A plus B plus C is equal to n pi, n pi means 180, 360, for all n belongs to Z plus RZ, whatever it is. Okay, so if A plus B plus C is equal to 180 or 360 or 3 pi, 4 pi, like that. So for this condition, now from this we can write A plus B is equal to n pi minus C, no? So like, so for this condition, when we apply the tan, then the statement becomes tan A plus tan B plus tan C is equal to tan A tan B tan C. Tan A tan B tan C. Okay, this is the identity. When we apply the cot, it becomes cot A cot B plus cot B cot C plus cot C cot A is equals to 1. Okay, so this diagram here. A plus B plus C is equal to n pi by 2. Pi by 2. Sorry. 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. 2n plus 1 into pi. And pi by 2. 3 pi by 2. 5 pi by 2. Like this. So at the time, we get the identities are. When we apply the, when we are taking the tans on both sides, we get tan A, tan B, tan C. Sorry, tan. So we get tan A, tan B, plus tan B, tan C. Tan B, tan C, plus tan C, tan A. Is equal to 1. So when we take cot A plus cot B plus cot C is equal to cot A, cot B, cot C. Okay, so these are the. So multiple of pi and odd multiple of pi. So reverse, these two are reverse. So for example, so here we have an example. So find the value of tan 27 into tan 32 degrees plus tan 32 degrees into tan 31 degrees plus tan 31 degrees into tan 27 degrees.
27, 32 and 31. 27 plus 32 plus 31 becomes 90. So, sum of three angles, A plus B plus C is equal to 90 degrees. So, then tan A, tan B plus tan B, tan C plus tan C, tan A is equal to 1. This is the answer. Directly right. So, the for this type of problems we use here. Okay? So, next. Right. The next, we continue next. So next, we discuss. Here, we have another some two important identities. If a problem in the form of sine theta plus sine alpha plus theta minus sine alpha minus theta, or a problem in the form of cos theta plus cos alpha plus theta minus plus cos alpha minus theta, like this. That means where instead of alpha, when we take 60 degree or 120 degrees or 240 degrees or 300 degrees, whatever it, when we take 240, 120, 60 and 300 instead of alpha, then these two values are becomes zero. This is the why we get. Suppose, for example, we have sine theta plus sine 60 plus theta minus sine 60 minus theta. Suppose a problem in the form of sine theta plus sine 60 plus theta. Sine. So find this value. What we do here? First, actually, in IP, what we do here? Sine theta write as it here, as it is. Next, which is the form? These two are the form. Sine of A plus B minus sine of A minus B. Sine of A plus B minus sine of A minus B. Here, sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Here, next, minus sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. Okay, so here by on expanding sine of A plus B, sine of A minus B, we write like this. Okay, so now sine 60 cos theta minus sine 60 cos theta. Then the remaining terms sine theta plus cos 60 sine theta minus it minus plus cos 60 sine theta, it becomes 2 cos 60 sine theta. Next, sine theta plus 2 into cos 60 means 1 by 2 into sine theta. So we have sine 60 minus theta, sine 60 plus theta. Okay, right. Here minus, here we get plus. Now get cancelled. Okay, problem take like this. Sine 60 minus theta minus sine 60 plus theta. Okay, sine 60 cos theta minus sine 60 cos theta get cancelled. So minus into minus, minus here. Next, we have 2 to get cancelled. So sine theta minus sine theta is equal to 0, like this. So most of the problems. And here, sometimes we may get 60, 120 or 240, 120 like that. So they also become 0, right? Next, suppose a problem in the form of
here we have another idea. Problem is the
sine 20 plus sine 40 minus sine 80.
Listen. Okay.
So what is the value of sine 20 plus sine 40? Sine 20 plus sine 40 sine 80. So sine 20 right as it is, unknown values. Okay. Next, sine 40 can be written as 60 minus 20. Sine 80 means 60 plus 20 on expanding. So we get
0.
Okay. So therefore,
so in this way we can do this one. That's why you have to remember these two ideas, some of the signs and some of the three causes of it. Okay.
Right. Next. Now discuss the identities on algebraic sum A plus B plus C, the angle A plus B plus C.
Right.
Here. So when we apply the ratio, sine ratio for A plus B plus C, what is the identity? So generally we can't remember this identity because it is very lengthy form. But just you have to remember three identities majorly. Sine of A plus B plus C is, can be written as sine of A plus B cos C plus cos of A plus B sine C. Okay? Here A plus B take as one angle and C is another angle in the form of A plus B. Sine of A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sin B. Okay? Next, sine of A plus B means again you write sine A cos B plus cos A sin B. Into cos A already is there. Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B into sin C. Instead of cos of A plus B, write the identity. So on expanding this, we get sin A cos B cos C. Cos A sin B cos C. Cos A cos B sin C minus sin A sin B sin C. So just you remember it. So in first term sin A and remaining two terms are cos B cos C. In second term is sin B. First term and third term is cos A cos C. In third term is cos A cos B and third term is sin C. So last term is sin A sin B sin C. It is having negative. So this is the identity of sin of A plus B. In that way you have to remember this identity. Similarly, we can write cos of A plus B plus C. Cos of A plus B plus C is equal cos A cos B. Cos A cos B cos C minus sin A sin B cos C minus sin A cos B sin C minus cos A sin B sin C. Okay, so this is the identity. So cos of A plus B cos C minus sin of A plus B sin C. Right. Next. Take only this is the way here also you have to remember like this, this way. Cos A cos B cos C, all terms of cos is this positive. Here cos C, third term is cos C. So next here second term is cos B. Next the third term is cos C. These three have negative terms. Okay. Next we write tan of A plus B plus C. Here also this is a very important identity better to use. Tan A plus tan B plus tan C. Tan A plus tan B plus tan C minus tan A tan B tan C divided by 1 minus tan A tan B minus tan B tan C minus tan C tan A. Okay.
This is the identity of tan of A plus B plus C. Simply, this is generally in second year we have theory of equations. In theory of equations, some of the roots denoted by S1, product of the roots denoted by S3, by 1 minus S2. Sum of the roots, sum of the three, product of the three roots, 1 minus, sum of the product of the roots taken to a determinant, minus of, minus combination of only, minus of tan A tan B, plus tan B tan C, plus tan C. So, you have to remember this. This is the identity of tan of A plus B plus C. So, these are the major identities in this compound angles. Okay, next. And also, very important thing is that, so generally in ratios already we got some values. So sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60, and sine 90, 180, 270, 360. Next, also we can find 120, 135. Okay, so in ratios, in basic chapter, already we know 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 45 degrees also, 90 degrees, 120 degrees, 135 degrees, 180 degrees, next 210 degrees, next 240 degrees, 225 degrees, next 270 degrees, 300, 315, 360, 310, 300, so like this. So in ratios, so we can find all these values because already these are the standard values, 30, 60, 45, 90, 180, and 270, 360, they are the quadrant values. So by using either 90 or 180, we can find 120, 135. Because 120 means 180 minus 60 or 90 plus 30. 135 means 180 minus 45 or 90 plus 45. So 210, 240, 225. By using 270 or here also we can find 150 also. 150 means 90 plus 60 or 180 minus 60. 180 minus 30. So 210 means 180 plus 30 or 270 minus 60. 240, 180 plus 60 or 270 minus 30, 225, 180 plus 45 or 270 minus 45, 300, 360 minus 60 or 180 plus 270 plus 30, 350, 360 minus 45 or 270 plus 45, 300. Okay, so already find these all values. Okay. So 330 also we can find because 360 minus 30 or 180 or 270 plus 60. In first chapter we discussed ratio. In ratios we already discussed these values. So now in this chapter, compound angles, we have some values. So what are they? See. So generally we know that 40 degrees, 45 degrees and 30 degrees. So 45 and 30. Or 60 like that. So when we subtract these two, 45 minus 30 becomes 15. So A minus B is equal. Next, 60 minus 45 is also 15. We can do that. So 45 plus 30 is 75. Also this. So that means 60 plus 45, 115. Like, sorry, 105. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss these type of angles. Okay. So first we write sine 15. Sine 15 means sine 15. Sine 15 can be written as sine 45 minus 30 degrees. Or we can write 60 minus 45 also, which is the form of sine of A minus B. Sine A cos B minus cos A sine B. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2, sin 30 is 1 by 2. So your LCM is 2 root 2, then 3 root 3 minus. This is the value of sin you can write cos 45 minus 30, cos 45, cos 30 plus sin 45, sin 30. It becomes root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2. Next, tan 15. Tan 15 is sin 15 by cos 15. Or we can write tan 45 minus 30. So, you know, root 3 minus 1 by root 3 plus 1 is the value. Actual value is, but by rationalizing we get 2 minus root 3. Tan 15 is equal to 2 minus root 3 by rationalization. Okay, next, cot 15. Cot 15 is equal to 2 plus root 3. Okay, so root 3 minus 1 by root 3 plus 1 into root 3 minus 1 by root 3 minus 1. So root 3 minus 1 whole square in numerator divided by 3 minus 1, 2. 3 plus 1 minus 2 root 3 by 2. So it becomes 4 minus 2 root 2 common, then 2 minus root 3. This is the value of tan 15 and cot. By using this, we can find sin 75, cos 75, tan 75, cot 75 also. Sin 75 means sin 90 minus 15 becomes cos 15. Cos 15 value is root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2. This is the sin 15. So cos 15, sin 75 are equal. Sin 15, cos 75 are equal. And tan 15 is nothing but 2 minus root 3. Tan 75, 2 plus root 3. Cot 75, 2 minus root 3. Like this. So these are the values in this. So then we write sec 15 also, 2 root 2 by root 3 plus 1. So here we get, by rationalizing, what we get here, root 3 minus 1 by root 3 minus 1 is equal to 2 root 6 minus 2 root 2 divided by 3 minus 1. 2 to get cancelled, root 2, root 6 minus root 2 is the value of sec 15. Then we write cosec 15, that is root 6 plus root 2. This is the. Okay. Yeah. Sir,